experience it. Right. Now we have one principle, one operating principle which we will use. What is the principle? The knower and the known must be different. What is the principle? The knower and the known must be different. What do I mean by that? Something very simple. I know this duster. I see this duster. My eyes are seeing this duster. In a very simple way, the eyes must be different from the duster to see it. I can see you. You must be different from my eyes for my eyes to be able to see you. In fact, the only thing that the eyes cannot see are the eyes themselves. The eyes can see a reflection of the eyes, can see a picture of the eyes, but they cannot see themselves directly. And they can see things which are different from themselves. So, the principle which we will use, which we will give up later on at the end, but right now we will use this principle, the knower and the known must be different. Okay, hold on to that. Let us start. I'll read out the Sanskrit. You can follow, you can just listen to me also. The verse goes like this. Rupam drishyam lochanam drik tad drishyam driktumanasam drishyadhivrittaya sakshi drigeva natu drishyate. Okay, the first part, it has four parts. The first part goes like this. Rupam drishyam lochanam drik. Rupam means form. Forms, these are forms. What you see. Literally rupam means color, but it also is extended to forms. Whatever the eyes can see, those are called rupam. All these are forms which you see. And who knows this? Please come. Who knows these forms? The eyes. Lochanam means eyes. So the eyes are the drashta and the forms are the drishya. Drashta means knower or seer and drishya means known or seen. You are with me so far? Very simple. Knower and the known. And what is the principle that we are using? The knower and the known must be? Eyes and the forms are obviously different. Very clearly, you know this. The process being adopted here is the usual method of education where you take the student from the known to the unknown. From what is familiar to what is unfamiliar. So it is very familiar. Eyes are different from what they see. Eyes are the seer, drig, and the forms are the drishya, the known, and they are different. Not only that, I'll make some other points. The first point I would like to make is, forms are many. Here are people, there are chairs, there are fans, and there is a hall, and there are so many colors, there is white and red and yellow and blue and so much. All these are forms, and they are all seen by the eyes, which are one. Not that the person is one-eyed, but it is one organ in the sense of seeing. So eyes, the drig, is an interesting point, is one. Drishya are many. Second point I would like to make, corollaries. Second point is, the drishya is constantly changing with respect to the drashta. With respect to the eyes, the things which it sees are constantly changing. People come and go, the day changes into night, and so many things which you are seeing, they keep on changing. They are changing. With respect to the changing forms, the eyes are relatively constant. Okay, 2 points I've made. Now, let's go to the second part, second quarter of the verse. Tadrishyam driktumanasam. Tadrishyam, these eyes, they become drishya. And who sees or knows the eyes? Mind. Manasam means mind. Don't you know your own eyes? No, in the sense, my eyes are open. My eyes are closed. I can't see clearly. I have to change the power of my spectacles. Or I can't see clearly. Or my eyes are itching. All the conditions of the eyes that I know clearly, that I can see clearly, or I cannot see clearly. Eyes are open, closed. All these conditions, they are known to the mind. So mind is the knower and the eyes are the known. Mind is the drashta, eyes are the drishya. eyes are the drishya. And what is the operating principle? Drashta and drishya, knower and known, must be different, they are separate. And obviously the mind is separate from my eyes. Remember, by the eyes I can extend it to the ears and to the nose and to the tongue and to the skin, to all the five sense organs. The same principle holds. The mind can know the sense organs. So the mind becomes the drig, the knower, the drashta, and the sense organs, the eyes and so on, they become the drishya, the known, the seen. And the same two corollaries, the different conditions of the eyes, or the different, first of all, the different sense organs, eyes, ears, tongue, nose, skin, all of them are known by the same mind. First corollary. Second corollary, they are changing. Condition of the eyes is changing, ears, skin, various sensations are coming, they are all changing. They are all known by the same mind. The two corollaries again hold. Now let us go further back. We are going, becoming more subtle. And you must move not only in understanding, but also in experience. You must feel it. Now we are coming to something really subtle. The third quarter. Drishya dhivrittaya sakshi. It says the mind, dhivritta means modifications of the mind. Dhivritti means modifications of the mind. Thoughts in your mind, emotions, feelings, knowledge, all of this is in the mind. And all of these, follow me carefully here, all of these are known to you. I am happy, I know that I am happy. I am sad, I know I am sad. I understand what this guy is talking about. I know I understand. I don't understand what he is talking about. I know I don't understand. So there is something in me which knows what's going on in the mind. There is something in us which watches our mind. Because everything in the mind is known. Don't ask who knows the mind. But just acknowledge this fact. Whatever is happening in your mind is known. Not to us maybe, but to you. It is known to you. Your happiness, your misery, your knowledge, your ignorance, your ideas, your memories, your feelings, all of them are very much known to you. And the principle is, there is a witness of the mind called the Sakshi. Sakshi means witness. It literally means witness. What it is, the verse is silent on that. But there is a witness to the mind. It's called Sakshi. Sakshi, as you know, in Hindi, in Sanskrit, it means the witness. Literally, it means the witness. So there is something which knows the various thoughts of the mind. And our principle is, knower and known must be different. Seer and the seen must be different. Drashta and Drishya must be different. Drashta and Drig are the same. Drig and Drishya must be different. So this Sakshi must be different from the mind. Whatever the Sakshi is, the knower of the mind must be different from the mind. There is a story about this. It's already, we are at a very deep level here. There is a story about this. One person who was very miserable, Sedji. Dukhi the. I'll just tell you in Hindi and translate back into English. Because I heard it in Uttarakhand in the Himalayas. Very profound story and very funny also. So there is this, I'll tell you in Hindi first. So Sedji the, bahut dukhi the. Woh ek Mahatma ji ke paas gaye Himalaya mein. Kya hua? Mahatma ji, hum bahut dukhi hain. Then that Mahatma told him, tum dukhi nahi ho, tum apne dukh ko jante ho tum. Apne man mein jo dukh hai, usko jante ho. हाँ जानते हैं इसीलिए आपके पास आए हैं हम दुखी हैं अगर तुम अपने दुख को जानते हो तो तुम दुखी नहीं हो सकते तुम अपने दुख के ज्ञाता हो अपने दुख के दृष्टा हो मन में जो दुख है उसका दृष्टा हो तुम सेठ जी सोचा बहुत हाँ ठीक ठीक बता रहे मन में दुख है उसके हम दृष्टा हैं नैन इवेंट एंड टोल्ड दी महात्मा महात्मा जी अब बहुत शांति है हम बहुत शांत है अब दुख चला गया हम बहुत शांत है नहीं तुम शांत नहीं हो तुम्हारे मन में जो शांति है उसका दृष्टा हो तुम What does it mean? I'll tell you in English. There was this man who was very sad and depressed and he went to this monk in the Himalayas. which is what Indians usually do. The higher you stay, you know, they literally say the higher you stay in the mountains, the more spiritual you are. So I asked this, I told you yesterday, I asked this monk who was some 15,000 feet high in the Himalayas above Gangotri, and what was it like? He said it was horrible. Let alone practice spiritual practices, meditation, it was difficult surviving there. Anyhow, and this man asked the monk there, Swamiji, I am very depressed, I am sad, I am miserable. And that Swami says, follow this, do you know the misery in your mind? Do you know your misery? He said, of course, I feel it. That's why I am here. I know it. If you know it, you cannot be miserable. You are the knower of your misery. You are the knower of the misery in the mind. And the knower and the known must be different. You think about this. And the man went and thought about it. And if you do that, you can try it yourself. After some time, you will get peace of mind. That misery will disappear. It becomes an object. Just like this thing in my chalk, the misery in your mind, the depression in your mind also becomes an object. And then it's no longer a cause of misery. So that's what happened to him. And he went back and he told the monk that, Swamiji, you are right. I am not miserable. Now I am very peaceful. Immediately the monk said, no, you are not peaceful. You are the knower of the peace in your mind. So why is it important? Because the moment you do this